Honorable Chancellor, sir, I have the honor to request you to declare the fourth convocation open.
I declare the convocation open. This convocation of the HNLU Raipur has been called to confer the degrees of PhD, LLM, and BA LLB honors upon the candidates who in the examinations held for the purpose have been certified to be worthy of the same.
Honorable Visitor of Hidayatullah National Law University and Chief Justice of India, Shri Sharad Arvind Bobde. Honorable Chief Minister of Chhattisgarh and Chief Guest for this convocation, Shri Bhupesh Baghel. Honorable Shri Justice Navin Sinha, Judge Supreme Court of India. Honorable Shri Justice R. Subhash Reddy, Judge Supreme Court of India. Honorable Shri Justice M. R. Shah, Judge Supreme Court of India. Honorable Chancellor of Hidayatullah National Law University and Chief Justice of Chhattisgarh, Shri P. R. Ramachandra Menon. Honorable Shri Mohammad Akbar, Minister in Charge of Law, Government of Chhattisgarh. Honorable Shri Umesh Patel, Minister in Charge of Higher Education, Government of Chhattisgarh. Honorable Shri Prem Sai Tekam, Minister in Charge of Tribal Affairs, Government of Chhattisgarh. Honorable Shri Justice Prashant Kumar Mishra, Judge, High Court of Chhattisgarh. Honorable Shri Justice Manindra Mohan Srivastava, Judge, High Court of Chhattisgarh. Honorable Shri Justice Parth Pratim Sahu, Judge, High Court of Chhattisgarh. Registrar in Charge of Hidayatullah National Law University, Dr. Deepak Kumar Srivastava. Honorable Members of the General Council, Executive Council, Academic Council and Finance Committee of HNLU, Faculty of HNLU, Graduating Batches of HNLU, Current Students of HNLU, Respected Guests, Well-Wishers of HNLU. I welcome you all to the fourth convocation of HNLU today to present the highlights of the university achievements and the blueprint for the future. Hidayatullah National Law University, established by the state of Chhattisgarh in 2003, is a frontline law university run under the seal of the Honorable Chief Justice of Chhattisgarh as its Chancellor. This convocation will shortly witness the graduation of 1,000 candidates of PhD, LLM and BA LLB honors courses belonging to the graduate batches of 2015-19. The detailed report of 5 years of graduation is a Herculean task to be presented in this function, and hence, with the permission of the Chancellor, I shall present the highlights of the combined batches of the and the detailed reports will be placed in the website later. HNLU has been ranked from 4th to 7th in various surveys of popular magazines like Outlook, UniRank of Sydney, among the national law universities in the country. HNLU bagged the Academic Excellence Award 2018 in Legal Desire Summit and also awards as Upcoming National Law University by the National Legal Summit Awards of 2015, to name a few awards. The HNLU students during the period of 2015-19 opted for diversified legal avenues like practice, corporate counsels, judicial officers, academic positions and higher education. A sizable students pursued their master's program with their favorite destination as that of Harvard Law School, University of London, Diplomatic Academy of Vienna, Stockholm School of Economics, Institute of Law and Finance in Germany, University of Melbourne and similar reputed institutes. In 2016, out of 14 Indian students who joined Harvard, 4 of them were from HNLU. On the career front, the placements included the frontline law firms like Amachand Mangaldas, Lakshmi Kumaran and Sridharan, Trilegal, Kaitan & Co, Nishit Desai Associates, Wadia Gandhi & Co, AZB and Partners, Quistlex, to name a few. The judicial services is a major attraction, and between 2015-17, a record number of HNLU alumni joined the judicial services. A good number of graduates after their master's program opted for the academic and teaching at national law universities and private law schools. Quite a few alumni are working in public policy sphere and even in financial management sector. On the clinical legal education front, there is a vibrant and competitive MOOC culture with our own annual flagship event called the HNMCC attracting law schools around the country and also our students brought laurels by participating and winning moods around the country and international competitions. The Chhattisgarh state government plays a pivotal role by funding around 1 crore every year for national and international moot participation, which also covers participation in international conferences. Highlights of some noteworthy performances in the period of 2015 to 2019 of the moot court circuits are Lex Infinitum, VMSCL, WMO, International Dispute Resolution Competition in 2017, 24th Wilhelm VIS International Commercial Arbitration Moot, again in Hong Kong East, organized by the Association of Organization and Promotion of the Wilhelm C. Wyss International Commercial Arbitration Moot. IASLA Space Law Competition 2017-18, organized by the International Air and Space Law Geneva. International rounds of the 10th Nelson Mandela World Human Rights Court Competition in 2018, organized by the University of Pretoria, South Africa. Also, they were in the qualifying rounds for the Oxford Intellectual Property Moot Court Competition, organized by the University of Oxford. As indicated, the complete details of the activities on this front for the above period is to be placed in the website. HNLU has a very vibrant sports and cultural festivities, branded as Colossus, with an international model United Nations event called IUMN, which also runs parallel to this festival. Both Colossus and IUMN all these years are a must participate event for many law schools across the country. IMUNC attracts delegates even from institutions abroad. The Learning Resource Center, traditionally known as a law library at HNLU, is an aesthetically designed three-storied, fully air-conditioned library similar to that of the London School of Economics, with a reading hall having a capacity of 650 persons. Apart from the online databases, the library has around 30,000 books, 32 international and national journals, and a diverse magazine section, along with a dedicated UN publication section. The LRC also has the Braille computer for the visually impaired. HNLU library is acclaimed today as one of the frontline libraries among the law school circuit. On the technical infrastructure, the university is a Wi-Fi campus and provides for 1 GB speed internet connectivity as part of the knowledge network NKN, with a state-of-the-art computer lab with 200 nodes connected by LAN. It is also equipped with a language lab for legal English courses. On the publications front, HNLU has launched its publication platform called HNLU Press, which publishes the flagship journal of the HNLU Journal of Law and Social Sciences and other special journals. The revamped HNLU newsletter, to be named as HNLU Gazette, is to be launched soon as a biannual publication. A dedicated student law journal is also on the anvil. The journals of HNLU are peer-reviewed journals and are placed as open access model. Another proactive clinical legal education wing is that of the Legal and Social Service Committee, or LSSC, which organizes various legal awareness programs by the students, and the notable are Samanvay Program, Anchal Memorial Blood Donation Camp, to name a few, in collaboration with the District Legal Service Authority. The student body under this wing actively participated in facilitating migrant workers to reach home during this pandemic. On the faculty front, HNLU currently has 30 faculty drawn from all over the country, and the strength is set to double by the coming semester. The faculty have been participating in various national conferences, workshops, faculty development programs, and publish regularly in academic journals. The university has designed the Cumulative Professional Development Allowance, called CPDA, in 2020, which amounts to rupees 1 lakh per year and a maximum of 3 lakhs for a block period of 3 years to each faculty. which can be used for attending conferences in India and abroad for paper presentation. The CPDA, designed in HNLU, is the first of its kind scheme among the national law universities in the country. The university has responded to the pandemic situation to equip digital preparedness with provisions of laptops, dongles, with data provision on other accessories to faculty and staff. The classes are done in a blended mode of live and uploaded lectures and is being scaled up for better delivery output. In April last year, the university launched the Sui Generis platform for faculty seminars, and 31 seminars were presented by the faculty on a wide range of topics in law and social sciences. On the new initiatives, in the last year, the university has initiated successfully several online initiatives. The Lex Osmos, which is a single credit online courses for the HNLU students and select outside students on topics ranging from constitutional law to artificial intelligence, were offered in 2 rounds of 8 programs, and this is going to be conducted every quarter of the year. The second initiative is a platform called XARCA, meaning out of the box, which had invited experts to dwell on contemporary topics like cyber crimes, IP, new education policy, law and constitution, to name a few. The third initiative is that of the platform called Alma Matters, which brought the prominent alumni of HNLU to discuss their experiences in public policy, law practice, and other areas. The fourth initiative is that of the formation of HNLU Press, which is a dedicated wing for online and offline publication of monographs, books, and journals. On the anvil is the formation of the HNLU Research Clusters, or HRC, which will have 5 major research hubs on the areas of public policy, arts and social sciences, technology and innovation, business laws, and international law. This HRC will be launched in the academic year of 2021. Also in the anvil is the HNLU Exchange Academy, otherwise branded as HEXA, for collaborations and exchange programs with institutes in India and abroad, is on the planning board and will be launched in the academic year of 2021. Having highlighted about HNLU and its achievements, now I would like to address the graduating students today. As far as the graduating students today, though I did not have the opportunity to teach or interact, I consider I am fortunate enough to connect with them through this special event. As I mentioned, this is not an ideal convocation one would have desired. It is a contingent one for career requirements. The university is actually contemplating for a convocation retro event in the year end or early next year, when the situation returns normal, to invite all of you to the campus for a get together through the Alma Matters Association. As far as the graduating candidates who are in practice now, I am reminded of the popular legal fiction writer John Grisham in his Rainmaker. I quote, "All students enter law school with a certain amount of idealism and desire to serve the public. But after 3 years of brutal competition, we care for nothing but the right job with the right firm, and we can make partner in 7 years and earn big bucks." I unquote. Is this condition of US true to the graduates of Indian law schools? I am afraid it is becoming one, if not already. This brings us to the audit of legal education system, its curriculum, pedagogy, contextualization, leadership, accountability, transparency, social engagement, public interest, and universal outlook. Given the inequity in terms of wealth, social relationship, and gender in our country, one can strongly advocate the balance of legal education should be in favor of social justice and public interest focus. The path to a sustained development squarely rests on equitable opportunities and thereupon the reward of excellence. Celebrating excellence among inequality is a myth and an exercise of deceit. Such a paradigm will find its own nemesis. A professional pursuit devoid of connecting with the reality is an exercise in futility. It is a hallucination which is distorted and disconnected from the path of progress. The term professional is often misconceived as a comparative notion where someone is technically smarter in their approach. The real meaning is that of engagement and relief to those who look forward to justice. The origin of the concept of professional is linked to that of public service. The various privileges today by the legal profession or in such context of public service, devoid of such attitude and engagement, one cannot claim to privileges as a professional birthright. It is essential to be reminded that career building should be equated to justice building exercise. If engineers build urban systems, doctors build immune systems, lawyers need to build justice systems. Economic success is easier in various other fields than legal profession. Then why legal profession? Legal profession is different than other professions where it has the power to assure in social justice and thereby a humane and civilized society. To quote Halpin, questions of social justice ought not to be irrelevant or peripheral to the study of law. They are more properly central to it when law operates in its noblest tradition. After all, it promotes a civilized and just social order. This requires setting personal examples of leadership for ourselves as teachers. Legal academics need to be role models of compassion, conviction, and care. This rubs off on the learners. It's a chain relationship. Legal academics, lawyers, judges, and thus the chain starts in law schools, which gets reflected in the bar and then in the bench. As alumni of HNLU, you will be remembered for the ideals you stand for. Your law school will be remembered for what you are. I take this occasion to wish the very best in your journey towards building a better tomorrow and would like to end with Aristotle's remark. I quote, "Dignity consists not in possessing honors, but in the consciousness that we deserve them." I repeat, dignity consists not in possessing honors, but in consciousness that we deserve them. I unquote. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Let the candidates for the degrees of PhD, LLM and BALLB honors be presented. Do you sincerely promise and declare that if admitted to the degree for which you are candidates and for which you have been recommended, you will, in your daily life and conversation, conduct yourself as worthy members of this university? Let the candidates for the PhD degree be presented.
Sir, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, PhD. The candidates have been found qualified for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, to which I pray the candidates may be admitted.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Chancellor, HNLU, Raipur, I admit you to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in this university.
Names of the admitted students of Doctor of Philosophy in Law are displayed herewith. Ms. Anukriti Mishra, Mr. Rana Navneet Roy.
Sir, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for the degree of Master of Laws, LLM, whose names are set out in the list. They have been found qualified for the degree of Master of Laws, to which I pray they may be admitted.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Chancellor, HNLU, Raipur, I admit you to the degree of Master of Laws in this university.
Batch-wise, names of the admitted students of LLM are displayed herewith.
Sir, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for the degree of BA LLB honors whose names are set out in the list. They have been found qualified for the degree of BA LLB honors to which I pray they may be admitted.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Chancellor HNLU Raipur, I admit you to the degree of BA LLB honors in this university.
Batch-wise, names of the admitted students of BLLB honors are displayed herewith.
Thank you.
The recipients of gold medal for BA LLB honors batch of 2015, Miss Prarthana Barnwal, Mr. Rahil Edward Pereira, Miss Tanya Sood, Miss Dipta Rao VN, Mr. B. Jayant Kumar, Miss Garima Panwar, Miss Apurva Singh, Miss Asmita Patel, Mr. Srivath Khare, Miss Vijaya Singh, the recipient of gold medals for BA LLB honors batch of 2016, Miss Shruti Sethi, Mr. Ananda Chakravarti, Miss Kajori Day, Ms. Ved Priya Lahari, Ms. Swati Srinath, Ms. Chinmay Das, Ms. Ayushi Agrawal, Ms. Kaikaha Yunus, Ms. Piyali Sengupta, Mr. Sachin Mishra, Ms. Shivi A. Goyal, the recipient of gold medals for BA LLB honors batch of 2017, Ms. Aastha Sinha, Ms. Kritika, Ms. Vaishali Goyal, Ms. Arpit Singhal, Ms. Ritvika Thakur, Mr. Saeed Jisan, Ms. काव्या कठपालिया, मिस नंदनी बंसल, मिस संस्कृति सिंह, मिस्टर त्रिविक्रम नायक। द रिसिपियंट्स ऑफ गोल्ड मेडल्स फॉर BLLB ऑनर्स बैच ऑफ 2018, मिस आयुषी द्विवेदी, मिस सौम्या झा, मिस दिव्या कश्यप, मिस्टर प्रांजल दोषी, मिस्टर उड्यन सान्याल, मिस्टर अभिनव सुरोलिया, मिस्टर अनमोल भल्ला, मिस आर्ची अग्रवाल, मिस आयुषी उपाध्याय, मिस्टर केविन जेम्स, मिस्टर निशित ब्रिखितु सिंह, मिस रूपाली साव। The recipients of gold medals for BLLB honors batch of 2019, Miss Priyanka Pirdarshini, Ms. Soumya Tandon. Ms. Anubhuti Jain. Ms. Shurbhi Agrawal. Ms. Urvi Gala. Mr. Anuj Singh Chauhan. Ms. Ishita Vyas. Ms. Meghna Thapar. Ms. Namrata. Ms. Nandini Sharma. Ms. Parul Sai. Ms. Peri Pratima. Ms. Priya Rathi. The recipients of gold medals for LLM program: Ms. Aditi Bharati of batch 2015, Ms. Ira Mishra of batch 2016, Ms. Shefali Singh of batch 2017. Ms. Nandini Upadhyay of batch 2018. Miss Jyoti Sharma, Batch 2019.
Honorable Chancellor, sir, I have the honor to request you to kindly deliver your address to the graduated candidates.
Honorable Visitor of the Hidayatullah National Law University and the Chief Justice of India, Mr. Justice Sharad Arvind Bobde. Honorable Chief Minister of the State of Chhattisgarh and the Chief Guest for the convocation, Sri Bhupesh Bakhel. Respected Vice Chancellor of the Hidayatullah National Law University, Professor V.C. Vivekanandan. Respected members of the General Council, Executive Council, Academic Council, and Finance Committee of the Hidayatullah National Law University. Faculty and students of the Hidayatullah National Law University. Graduating batches of the Hidayatullah National Law University, their parents and relatives. Other dignitaries and well-wishers of the Hidayatullah National Law University watching this virtual convocation program, ladies and gentlemen. A very good morning to all of you. I wish you all a glittering new year, filled with hopes and expectations all around. It is my pleasure to address the gathering, being my first convocation address as the Chancellor of this prestigious university. As you know, we are passing through a difficult time. Months ago, being struck hard by the alien pandemic, we were praying for the angels to come and save the world. Fortunately, the angels are here in the form of scientists who invented the vaccine for COVID-19 and as other COVID warriors in the medical and non-medical field from top to bottom. I am proud to say that all of us, including the bar and the bench, as well as the academic institutions, could contribute whatever little possible to tide over the situation, supporting the various measures taken by the central and the state governments. Though today's function is being arranged on a virtual platform, all earnest efforts have been taken to preserve its fervor in all respects. Lawyer's profession is said to be a noble profession. It is the only profession specifically mentioned in our Constitution. Article 22.1 says, that no person arrested shall be denied of his right to consult and to be defended by a legal practitioner of his choice. I can see the sparkling joy and enthusiasm in your eyes. It takes me back to the date of my enrollment a little less than 4 decades ago. The only difference is that those days, most of us were simply flowing with the tide, whereas now the students are much focused. You have good academic background and large exposure. You know the pulse as to what, where, why. The opportunities are wide, either as lawyers, law officers, consultants, academicians, or as judges once you get selected. Modern law universities, especially the national law universities, have contributed quite a lot in this regard by grooming the students to get focused and to hit the target at the right spot, giving the right punch. It is often said the students are the ambassadors of the education institutions. It's also said one has to be melted before molded. This process of melting and molding to be a successful, professional and responsible citizen of tomorrow is the job being done in this university. The opportunity given to you is a privileged one, offered by the state through contribution of every citizen, and it puts some responsibility as well for helping to change the lives of the people. Law as a profession has a task of nation building and reforming our social system than mere dispute resolution. The attempt of any law school shall be to shape up your skills, values, and outlook for raising the standards of the bar, which in turn will get transmitted for raising the standards of the bench as well. Some tips on my concept as a good lawyer. Prepare and study the case well before making submissions in the court. Don't be under the impression that you know everything, being the product of a national law school. If you take the knowledge as unity, only 1/4 you acquire from the teachers, 1/4 you acquire by yourself, 1/4 from the colleagues, and remaining 1/4 by the passage of time. So nobody is complete on a given date. Therefore, keep your door always open to acquire knowledge from all corners and get it updated. Communication skill. There is a chance for huge transmission loss of the data from the point of your reception till it is conveyed and applied at the other end by the recipient judge. As such, clarity of thought and expression using apt words is a practice to be polished and preserved. Court craft is another skill that is to be acquired by watching the proceedings in the court, and naturally it will take time. There is a saying in Sanskrit, Satyam Bruyat, Priyam Bruyat, Na Bruyat, Satyam Apriyam, which insists to tell the truth, but never the bitter truth. But according to me, even if it is a bitter truth, present it in a palatable form. There may be some rulings against you, but don't ignore them. Cite them and try to distinguish with reference to the relevant facts of your case and win the confidence of the court. Fairness. You have to be fair to the client, of course. You have to be fair to the court as well, being an officer of the court. And you have also to be fair to the opposite side. If the court asks you what is the correct position of law, then that is the moment when you are supposed to realize that the court is reposing confidence in you and wants to your help to resolve the issue. It is a moment when you are supposed to say only the correct position to be applied by the court, as you have got a duty to see that the court does not go wrong. Most important among all is the professional ethics. Never compromise with the professional ethics in your attempt to earn money. This will pay in the long run, and the money will come your way. You may also please refer to the do's and don'ts mentioned by the eminent lawyer F.S. Nariman in his autobiography Before Memory Fades, so as to get molded as a better lawyer. Young friends, if you ask me my suggestion as to what you shall be, my answer is very simple. Excel yourself as a worthy, responsible citizen with a commitment to the society. Be a model, whatever you are, wherever you are. I conclude by quoting a small stanza in Sanskrit, which is from the Taittiriya Upanishad. Matra Devo Bhava, Pitra Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, Atithi Devo Bhava. Matra Devo Bhava means be a person to whom mother is God, not your mother alone, but all the mothers, wipe out their tears. Pitra Devo Bhava, be a person to whom father is God, not your father alone, but all the fathers of hapless children, extend a helping hand to them. Acharya Devo Bhava, be a person to whom teacher is God, not your teacher alone, all the teachers who inculcate the values of life and instill the spirit of public service for proper nation building. Atithi Devo Bhava, be a person to whom guest is God, serve others before appropriating anything yourself. I would like to add one thing more, be a person to whom constitution is God. Please have a look at the fundamental duties under chapter 4A of our constitution as well, though it cannot be enforced through a court of law, while pressing for your fundamental rights under chapter 3. Dear students of law, earn a name for your parents, get laurels for your teachers, bring glory to the institution, and be a proud Indian. Let this be your Guru Dakshina. I wish you everything best in life and career. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Honorable visitor, sir, I have the honor to request you to kindly deliver the special address.
Shri Bhupesh Baghel, Honorable Chief Minister of the State of Chhattisgarh, Justice Ramachandra Menon, the Honorable the Chief Justice of Chhattisgarh, Chancellor of Hidayatullah National Law University, Professor V.C. Vivekanandan, Vice Chancellor of Hidayatullah National Law University, members of the General Council, Executive Council, Academic Council, and Finance Committee of the University, faculty members, graduating batches of Hidayatullah National Law University, beloved students, ladies and gentlemen. It is a matter of great honor and proud privilege for me to be with you today at your convocation. Your university is named after one of the finest judges of this country, Shri Muhammad Hidayatullah, former Chief Justice of India. As a tribute to his contributions to the country, not only as an eminent jurist, but also as Vice President of this country. Firstly, I would like to congratulate each and every one of you, the students, their parents and families, as well as the members of the faculty who have given each one of you graduating students a strong support system in channelizing your future path effectively. You deserve to be proud of your achievements. Dear students, today is an occasion to celebrate as well as reflect. While your formal training has come to an end, the process of learning will always continue throughout the rest of your lives. Amongst other professions, being a lawyer would mean that you will be a lifelong student. While this graduation day is happening through the virtual mode, as a consequence of the pandemic, thereby depriving all of you of all the excitement, joy, and camaraderie of a physical convocation, you will not be able to make catcalls. We need to commend and console ourselves that we are moving ahead with a resolve to deal with challenging times and continue our journey towards our professional goals. There is a famous saying that the man who graduates today and stops learning tomorrow is uneducated the day after. The road to success isn't always a bed of roses. The world outside may not be as benevolent as campuses are. But one thing is certain, that those who decide to doggedly tread the road ahead are bound to achieve the success they desire. As a visitor of this university, I have an emotional connect on two counts with Justice Hidayatullah. Firstly, I am a successor to his office at the Supreme Court. Justice Hidayatullah served as the 11th Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of India. I serve as its 47th. On the second count, I hail from Nagpur, where Justice Hidayatullah completed his education and later practiced as an advocate, then as government leader, then as Advocate General of the state. He was then elevated as a judge of the Nagpur High Court, which is now located in Jabalpur. This is an emotional geographical connect which I cherish. Justice Hidayatullah has been the only jurist so far to have served the country as its Chief Justice, Acting President of India, and an elected Vice President of India. This eminent jurist and an illustrious statesman of our country is undisputedly a role model to emulate for all those graduating today. I am sure you must have read my own Boswell, The Memoirs of Justice Hidayatullah. The National Law Universities has established interdisciplinary institutes in the last 3 decades, and that has changed the landscape of legal education in terms of choice, content, and career of bright and young aspirants in the field of law. The aspirants for legal education are increasing every year. and there is strong competition. The challenge is not that of procuring an admission to a frontline law university, but one of how an individual fulfills the expectation of society after their graduation. Degrees are just a piece of paper if one doesn't contribute to society. A university must be able to contribute to the well-being of society. A degree puts an obligation on its graduates to strive towards the achievement of purposes for which it was established. Younger generation of lawyers like you are more fortunate to have avenues of information and platforms for expression and avenues of revenue generation than those from yesteryears. What attracts scores of people to this profession? It is not the dream of earning a fortune only, but more the passion and urge of preserving the rights and values enshrined in our Constitution. The famous entrepreneur Henry Ford once said, "Wealth, like happiness, is never attained when sought after directly. It comes as a byproduct of providing useful service." The history of the independence struggle will tell you the immense role which advocates have played in securing the independence of this country. In today's world, there are spaces which can boast about economic supremacy and spaces which can flaunt technological prowess. But the long-lasting ones are spaces which preserve, nourish, and enhance the process of the rule of law. This was aptly espoused by Aristotle when he said, "At his best, man is the noblest of all animals. Separated from law and justice, he is the worst." I don't know of any other profession which demands such a versatility of intellect and a wide range of knowledge as the profession of law does. There are so many branches one is tempted to learn as a lawyer. As one goes along, it is fascinating to see the interconnectedness each branch of law has with the other. The myriad rights which each law confers and their impact on the case before the court. It is fascinating to see the functioning of the Suprema Lex, the Constitution, and its various provisions. It is like a view from the mountaintop. Whatever branch you take, the demands of the profession are exacting, but the rewards are many. Not just a big income, but a sense of intellectual achievement, growth, and usefulness to society. We are managing a terrible crisis throughout the country, throughout the world, with hope and determination. The fury of nature, which we have disrespected, in a way has audited flaws in terms of our unpreparedness and misplaced development priorities, not just in India, but all over the world. Never before has the pressure on the judiciary and the universities to solve issues been so high. On the lessons learnt and preparedness for tackling future crises of this scale, it is imperative to formulate a cohesive and comprehensive public policy on health, transport, public distribution, and related matters. Such legislative inputs require the contribution of young, bright lawyers from universities such as yours to play a pivotal role. I am confident and hopeful that the future of our democracy and the rule of law will fare better with committed and dedicated graduates like you entering the legal profession. But it will take time before you get into your stride. You will have to tread the path carefully and slowly. I am reminded of a quotation which Justice Hidayatullah made in his convocation speech at the University of Madras. He said, quoting the original, "Shanay Pantha, Shanay Kantha, Shanay Parvatalanghanam, Shanair Vidya, Shanair Vittam, Panchayatani, Shanay Shanay." It means these five things in life you must go about very slowly. Undertaking a long journey, handling a long piece of cloth, climbing a mountain, acquiring knowledge, and making a lot of money. Go slowly. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Honorable Chief Minister, sir, I have the honor to request you to kindly deliver the convocation address to the graduated students.
हिदायतुल्ला राष्ट्रीय विधि विश्वविद्यालय के माननीय कुलाध्यक्ष और भारत के मुख्य न्यायाधीश श्री शरद अरविंद बोबड़े जी, माननीय कुलपति और छत्तीसगढ़ उच्च न्यायालय के मुख्य न्यायाधीश श्री पी आर रामचंद मेनन जी, माननीय कुलपति प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर वी सी विवेकानंदन जी, रजिस्ट्रार इंचार्ज डॉक्टर दीपक कुमार श्रीवास्तव जी, विश्वविद्यालय के सामान्य परिषद, कार्यकारी परिषद, शैक्षणिक परिषद और वित्त समिति के सम्मानित सदस्य, विश्वविद्यालय के शिक्षक एवं कर्मचारीगण, विश्वविद्यालय के स्वर्ण पदक एवं उपाधि प्राप्त करने वाले समस्त छात्र एवं छात्राएं, विश्वविद्यालय में अध्ययनरत समस्त छात्र एवं छात्राएं, हिदायतुल्ला राष्ट्रीय विधि विश्वविद्यालय छत्तीसगढ़ और देश का गौरव है। छत्तीसगढ़ राज्य की स्थापना के बाद पहले 3 वर्ष में स्थापित होने वाला यह पहला राष्ट्रीय संस्थान है। ऐसे गौरवशाली संस्थान के चतुर्थ दीक्षांत समारोह को संबोधित करते हुए मुझे अत्यंत हर्ष हो रहा है। मुझे बताया गया है कि आज का यह दीक्षांत समारोह वर्चुअल माध्यम से दुनिया भर में देखा जा रहा है। इस विश्वविद्यालय के पूर्व छात्रों ने उच्च अध्ययन के लिए ऑक्सफोर्ड, कैम्ब्रिज, हार्वर्ड जैसे अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर प्रतिष्ठित विश्वविद्यालयों में प्रवेश लिया है। बहुत सारे छात्र छात्राओं ने वहाँ से सफलतापूर्वक डिग्री भी हासिल कर ली है। यह इस बात का प्रमाण है कि इस विश्वविद्यालय में शिक्षा की नींव कितनी मजबूत है। हमें इस बात का भी गर्व है कि हिदायतुल्ला विधि विश्वविद्यालय जैसा देश का श्रेष्ठ संस्थान छत्तीसगढ़ में है। इस संस्थान से अब तक 5 बैचों ने बीए, एलएलबी, एलएलएम और पीएचडी का कोर्स सफलतापूर्वक पूरा कर लिया है। आज जिन छात्र छात्राओं ने उपाधि प्राप्त कर ली है उन सभी को बहुत बहुत बधाई। यहाँ से आप लोगों की एक नई राह प्रारंभ होती है। यह बहुत ही जिम्मेदारीपूर्ण राह है। आप सबको उस जिम्मेदारी को समझना होगा। समाज में हमेशा कानून का राज कायम रहे, यह जिम्मेदारी आपके ही कंधों पर है। इस नई राह पर आप सफल हों, समाज और देश के लिए योगदान कर सकें, इसके लिए मेरी ओर से आप सबको बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं। भारतीय लोकतंत्र में संविधान सर्वोच्च है। संवैधानिक मूल्यों के अनुरूप इस विशाल लोकतंत्र का संचालन हो, इसमें आपकी भागीदारी बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है। विभिन्न वर्गों के बीच विविधता वाले देश भारत के लोकतंत्र को सामाजिक, राजनीतिक और आर्थिक न्याय प्रदान करने के लिए अभी भी गंभीर एवं सार्थक प्रयासों की आवश्यकता है। इसके लिए एक गतिशील कानून, संवेदनशील न्यायिक प्रणाली की आवश्यकता है। यह सार्थक लोकतंत्र की स्थापना का मार्ग प्रशस्त होगा। कानूनी शिक्षा का उद्देश्य न केवल कानूनी कौशल की तकनीकी शिक्षा हासिल करना है, बल्कि इसके माध्यम से समाज की संरचना को समझने का एक व्यापक कैनवास का निर्माण करना है, ताकि जनता को राहत पहुंचाने के लिए इस कौशल का उपयोग किया जा सके। आप इस समाज में व्याप्त असमानता को समझते हैं। आप इस बात को समझते हैं कि इस असमानता को मिटाने के लिए किन लोगों को आपको सबसे ज़्यादा ज़रूरत है। आपको आज ही तय कर लेना चाहिए कि आपके भविष्य की दिशा क्या होगी। आपके पास एक अवसर है कि आप भी महात्मा गांधी, पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू, डॉक्टर राजेंद्र प्रसाद जैसे प्रख्यात वकीलों की परंपरा में अपना भी नाम दर्ज करा पाएं। जिस तरह इन महापुरुषों ने भारत को स्वतंत्रता दिलाने के लिए अपने कानूनी ज्ञान और कौशल का उपयोग किया, उसी तरह स्वतंत्र भारत में नए समाज के निर्माण में आप अपना योगदान दे सकते हैं। यह विश्वविद्यालय जस्टिस मोहम्मद हिदायतुल्ला के नाम पर है। वे न केवल एक प्रख्यात न्यायविद थे, बल्कि उपराष्ट्रपति और कार्यवाहक राष्ट्रपति के रूप में भी देश की सेवा करने वाले एक प्रख्यात स्टेट्समैन थे। पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू कहते थे, शिक्षा का उद्देश्य न सिर्फ अपना बल्कि साथ साथ सभी का कल्याण करना होना चाहिए। आप लोगों को इस बात का गर्व हमेशा रहेगा कि आपने एक ऐसे संस्थान से शिक्षा पाई है जो कानूनी शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में देश के शीर्ष 10 संस्थानों में से एक है। यह विश्वविद्यालय समाज के सभी वर्गों को उत्कृष्टता हासिल करने का अवसर प्रदान करता है। यह प्रसन्नता की बात है कि इस विश्वविद्यालय में सभी स्तरों में समाज के सभी वर्गों के लिए उत्थान के अवसर खुले हुए हैं और उनकी विषम परिस्थिति उनकी उत्कृष्टता में बाधा नहीं है। हमारी सरकार इस प्रतिष्ठित विश्वविद्यालय की हर संभव मदद करने के लिए हमेशा तत्पर रही है। राज्य सरकार हर साल इस विश्वविद्यालय को 4 से 5 करोड़ रुपये का वार्षिक अनुदान देकर आर्थिक सहायता करती है। आवश्यकता पड़ने पर हम और भी अधिक आर्थिक सहायता देंगे। हिदायतुल्ला विधि विश्वविद्यालय देश का एकमात्र राष्ट्रीय विधि विश्वविद्यालय है, जिसे राज्य सरकार द्वारा 1 करोड़ की विशेष आर्थिक सहायता प्राप्त होती है। इसका उपयोग छात्र छात्रा राष्ट्रीय और अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर मूट कोर्ट प्रतियोगिताओं तथा सम्मेलनों में भाग लेने के लिए करते हैं। मुझे यह जानकर प्रसन्नता हुई है कि विश्वविद्यालय ने राज्य के विकास में सहयोग करने के लिए राज्य योजना आयोग के साथ एक समझौता ज्ञापन पर हस्ताक्षर किए हैं। ठाकुर प्यारेलाल राज्य पंचायत एवं ग्रामीण विकास संस्थान रायपुर के शासक मंडल में इस विश्वविद्यालय के माननीय कुलपति पदेन सदस्य हैं। मैं यही कामना करता हूं कि यह विश्वविद्यालय दिनों दिन उत्कृष्टता की नई नई ऊंचाइयों को छुए, विधि क्षेत्र में न केवल भारत का सर्वश्रेष्ठ संस्थान बने, बल्कि इसकी गिनती विश्व के सर्वश्रेष्ठ संस्थानों में है। दूसरे देशों के लोग शिक्षा प्राप्त करने के लिए छत्तीसगढ़ आए। मैं एक बार फिर आज उपाधि धारण कर रहे सभी विद्यार्थियों को बहुत बहुत बधाई देता हूँ। इस विद्यालय के समस्त विद्यार्थियों के उज्जवल भविष्य की कामना करता हूँ। इस दीक्षांत समारोह में आमंत्रित करने के लिए माननीय कुलाधिपति, माननीय कुलपति एवं विश्वविद्यालय को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। जय जवाहर, जय छत्तीसगढ़, जय हिंद।
Honorable Chancellor, sir, I request you to dissolve the convocation.
I dissolve the convocation.
जनगण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड़ उत्कल वंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।